I'm Maria, and today I'm going to show you how to remove Chrome extensions. Google Chrome is one of the most popular browsers in the world, and many quality extensions that can add to your online experience are available. Sometimes, however, the extensions we download and install don't live up to our expectations, or we simply stop using them. When that happens, you need to know how to remove Chrome extensions, lest they interrupt or slow down your browser. In this video, we're going to discuss several ways you can disable or remove extensions from Google Chrome. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there will be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's look at how to temporarily disable Chrome extensions. Sometimes you don't need to uninstall your Chrome extensions permanently. You may need to just disable them temporarily. Chrome includes an extensions hub where you can easily access all of your extensions currently installed. You can get there through the three-dot menu on the upper right hand of your browser window or by typing this URL into your search bar like you see here. You'll notice that under each extension, there are a few options. You'll see a button marked Details, another marked Remove, and a slider on the right-hand side with a dot on it. This slider is what we're focusing on in this step. If the slider is on the right in blue, the extension in question is active. If it's on the left in white, the extension is not active. Simply click on any active slider to temporarily disable the extension. There is no timer on this feature, so you'll have to physically reactivate it once again when you decide it's needed. The next way to temporarily disable extensions is by using another extension. In the Chrome Web Store, you'll find an extension called Disable Extensions and Apps. With this extension, you can disable and re-enable your extensions and apps using the keyboard command Control-Shift-E. Doing this disables all apps and extensions, with the exception of those you've labeled as whitelist. You can also accomplish this by using a simple Windows command. Simply type the following command. Once it's copied, open a Windows search box and paste it in. After that, hit Enter and you're good to go. If you decide that a temporary deactivation just isn't good enough, then you need to learn how to remove Chrome extensions. Chrome makes this process quick and easy, as long as you follow a few simple steps. It's way faster and easier than trying to delete a Google review. First, click on the three dots in the upper right-hand corner of your Chrome browser. Clicking this will open a drop-down menu. Scroll down to More Tools and hover your mouse over it. This will open up another submenu on the left-hand side. Navigate to that new menu and click on the tab marked Extensions. Doing this opens the Google Chrome Extensions Manager. As you can see in this example, the Extensions Manager displays all of your installed extensions. In this example, one of the extensions is marked as having violated the Google Chrome Web Store's policies, so that's the one we're going to remove. Under each extension, there are two options, Details or Remove. Click Remove under the extension that you don't want. This opens up a confirmation tab where you can confirm that you want to remove the extension. You can even report abuse here if needed. Once that's done, the extension is no more. You can also delete Chrome extensions right from the browser toolbar. Just find the icon of the extension you want to delete and right-click on it if you're using a PC, or hold down Control and click on it if you're using a Mac. This will bring up a submenu. Once there, click on the tab that says Remove from Chrome. You will then be asked for confirmation that you want to delete the extension. Confirm that this is your intention and click Remove when prompted by the system. The toolbar method we just described can't be used to disable an extension, but you can use it to open the extension manager and disable it from there. Maybe you don't want to just remove a single extension. Perhaps you're done with Chrome extensions altogether and want to wipe the slate completely clean. Either way, it's important that you know how to remove Chrome extensions when needed. There are two different methods for going about this. The first and easiest is to go directly through the Chrome browser itself. This process will run a lot like the last step in the extension removal process outlined earlier, only with repeated steps for each Chrome extension on your list. First, go to the Chrome Extensions Hub. You can do this by typing the Chrome Extensions URL into your search bar or by clicking on the three-dot menu on the upper right, then More Tools, and finally Extensions. Once you're in the Extensions Hub, you can start disabling all of your extensions, one at a time. Under each extension, you'll see the Details and Remove buttons, along with the slider that disables extensions without uninstalling them. There is no option to turn all extensions off simultaneously, so you will have to click Remove on each service. However, this isn't as time-consuming as it sounds. Just click on Remove for each extension and confirm that you want to remove it from your Chrome browser. If you're a Windows user, you can use a much more complicated process to uninstall your Chrome extensions manually. First, find the default folder location for your operating system. Type the following into a Windows search. Just make sure to substitute your actual username where it says username. Once you make it inside the default folder, there will be a folder marked Extensions. When you open that, there will be folders for each extension you have installed. However, these folders' names might look like a long jumbled mess. Opening one of these folders reveals a subfolder with the version number of your extension. When you open that subfolder, it will tell you the name of the extension you're looking at. You can then back out of this folder, returning to those with the long, messy names. Simply delete those folders and restart Chrome. The extension will be gone. Removing a Chrome extension doesn't always get the job done. There could be hidden extensions and files still sitting on your device, taking up space. However, there is a way you can remove those extensions from your hard drive completely. This process will look a little different depending on your operating system. When it's time to remove hidden extensions from your Windows system, you'll have to first go to the Chrome installation location. Typically, you can find it here. Open the folder marked Extensions to find a list of your extensions, then delete the folder of the extensions you don't want, and restart your browser. This will make the change take effect. If you're using a Mac, you'll be able to find your extension installation location by going here. If you're signed into different Google accounts within Chrome, there will be different folders for each username. The folders inside will all have long 32-character names. Reopen Chrome and go back to your Extensions Hub by either typing in the Chrome Extensions URL or clicking on the three dots on the upper right side, selecting More Tools and clicking on Extensions. When you're in the Hub, click on the tab marked Developer Mode. Once the developer mode is turned on, it will look something like this. Developer mode shows you the 32-character identifiers for each extension. Go back to your hard drive folder, find the proper extension using this information, and delete it from your system. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. We offer 2 months free with any annual plan, a 30-day money-back guarantee, and unlimited free basic migrations from any host. Head over to kinsta.com/plans to get started. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.